Hi students, welcome to the channel NCERT Maths Tutor. If you like this video, please click the like button, share and subscribe. In this video, I'm explaining the solution of exercise 4.1, question number 10, chapter 4, Principle of Mathematical Induction. Question number 10, 1 by 2 into 5 plus 1 by 5 into 8 plus 1 by 8 into 11 plus so on up to plus 1 by 3n minus 1 into 3n plus 2 is equal to n by 6n plus 4. Now let us take this given statement as P of n. The first step is we have to prove the given statement for n is equal to 1. So to prove for n is equal to 1, here from the left hand side, I will consider the first term of the statement. The first term of the statement is 1 by 2 into 5. So that I am taking for LHS. So 1 by 2 into 5 is equal to, on the RHS, here we have the entire term n by 6n plus 4. This I am taking. So wherever you have n, replace that with the value 1. Because here we are checking for n is equal to 1. So here this becomes 1 divided by 6 into 1 plus 4. So this is 1 by 2 into 5. That is nothing but 1 by 10 is equal to, here we have 1 by 6 plus 4. That is also 1 by 10. So LHS is equal to RHS. That means now we can say that the given statement is true for n is equal to 1. So now we have proved this statement for n is equal to 1. Next step is that in the second step, here we take a positive integer k and we assume that the given statement is true for that positive integer. That means now we write the statement in the form of P of k. How we can write the statement in the form of P of k? That means wherever you have n, replace that with the value k. So if you're writing this statement in the form of P of k, then here you have to make P of k. Then here everywhere, wherever we have n, replace that with the value k. So here we get a P of k statement as P of k 1 by 2 into 5 plus 1 by 5 into 8 plus 1 by 8 into 11 plus so on up to plus 1 by 3k minus 1 into 3k plus 2 is equal to k divided by 6k plus 4. Now let us take this one as statement 1. This is our assumption. Now in the third step, by using the assumption, we have to prove that the given statement is also true for P of k plus 1. And if you prove that, that means the statement is true for all the set of natural numbers. So now here we already we have here P of k statement. So what I do is this, again I will write P of k plus 1 statement. How we can write P of k plus 1 statement? To write that, here after this P of k, you have to add one k plus 1 term. Then the right hand side also becomes k plus 1. So now let us write the P of k plus 1 statement. See, P of k plus 1, 1 by 2 into 5 plus 1 by 5 into 8 plus 1 by 8 into 11 plus so on up to plus 1 by 3k minus 1 into 3k plus 2. This is for k term, plus now we are writing k plus 1 term. So after this, add one more term, that is k plus 1 term. So wherever you have here k, make that one as k plus 1. So after this, we have one more term plus 1 by 3 into c. This k you have to replace with the value k plus 1. 3 into k plus 1 minus 1 into, here also this k you need to replace with the value k plus 1. 3 into k plus 1 plus 2. Then is equal to, see now here the left hand side is the k plus 1 term. This, in this P of k, this is for k term. If it is for k term, here we have k divided by 6k plus 4. Now here the left hand side is for k plus 1 term. It is up to k plus 1 term. That means here, wherever you have here k, that you have to replace with k plus 1. So P of k plus 1 right hand side becomes k plus 1, here we have k, replace that with k plus 1 divided by 6. Again, here we have k, replace that with the value k plus 1 plus 4. So now here we have to prove this right hand side. So how we can prove that? To prove this right hand side, you first take the left hand side of p of k plus 1. And then if you reach to the right hand side, that means we can say that the statement is true for p of k plus 1. Now let us take the left hand side of p of k plus 1, where we have 1 by 2 into 5 plus 1 by 5 into 8 plus 1 by 8 into 11 plus sewn up to plus 1 by 3k minus 1 into 3k plus 2 plus the k plus 1 term. See here, on this left hand side, if you compare the p of k statement which we have written in the previous page, that is our assumption, and this here, this much part is nothing but that is p of k, right? Already we know we have made this assumption. So this assumption we can use here. So p of k is 1 by 2 into 5 plus 1 by 5 into 8 plus so on up to here, that is nothing but k divided by 6k plus 4. That means this much part I can replace with the value k divided by 6k plus 4. Why I am replacing that? Because we have made already some assumption in the step 2. From that assumption, we get this one, k divided by 6k plus 4 plus the remaining term, k plus 1 term, right, as it is. See here, 1 divided by, just multiply the value, 3k plus 3. So 3k plus 3 minus 1 into 3k plus 3 plus 2. Then next step is here, 3k plus 3 minus 1, we have 3 minus 1, that means 2. So 3k plus 2, this becomes, then 3k plus 3 plus 2, this becomes 3k plus 5. And here you can take the common value 2 as out. So here we get 2 if you take out, 3k plus 2. Then next step is that, see, among these two denominator, you can take the common denominator, that is 2 into 3k plus 2 into 3k plus 5. This is our denominator. So that here, this part become k into 3k plus 5, because 3k plus 5 we don't have here in this denominator. So that's why k into 3k plus 5 plus, here we have 3k plus 2 into 3k plus 5 here. So 2 we don't have. So that 2 will come here, 2. So now see, just multiply the value, k into 3k, that is 3k square, plus k into 5, 5k plus 2 divided by 2 into 3k plus 2 into 3k plus 5. See, we need to reach to this solution. So that's why here, now what I do is, this 5k, whatever we have, this I am splitting in two parts. That 5k I am writing as 3k plus 2k, which is nothing but 5k only. The reason for that is I want to take the common values out. If I write like this way, then from this term, from these two terms, I can take 3 out. And from these two terms, I can take 2 out. So that is the reason I am splitting this 5k into 3k plus 2k. So now here we have this, from this we can take the common value as 3k out. So 3k if I take out, the remaining is k plus 1 here, plus from this I can take 2 out. So the remaining is k plus 1 divided by 2 into 3k plus 2 into 3k plus 5. See now here, if you compare this and this term, in the first term k plus 1 we have, in the second term also we have k plus 1. That means you can take k plus 1 term out again. So if I take k plus 1 term out, here the remaining is 3k plus, here the remaining term is 2 divided by, write the remaining values as it is, 2 into 3k plus 2 into 3k plus 5. Then again you can cancel these values, then we get here k plus 1 divided by 2 into 3k plus 5, right? But what answer we need to get? We need to reach to this solution. See, already in the numerator we got k plus 1, but in the denominator we have this one. We need to get like this way. So that's why what I do is here, see, I will try to take, I will try to get here 6. Here we have 2. So that's why this 5 I am splitting and writing as 3 plus 2, so that I can take 3 out. So this 5 I will write as 3 plus 2 here. So now if you take these two terms, from these two terms you can take 3 out. So we have here k plus 1 divided by 2 into, from these two terms, I'm taking 3 out. So the remaining is k plus 1 plus 2. Now, just multiply the value to this as well as to this with this 2. So k plus 1 divided by 2 into 3, that is 6k plus 1 plus 2 into 2, that is plus 4 is equal to, that is nothing but our RHS. See here, we have to prove this one, P of K plus 1 statement that we have written in the previous page, and we reached to that solution. That means now we can say that the statement P of K plus 1 is true whenever P of K is true. So hence, by principle of mathematical induction, now we can say that the statement, the given statement, P of n is true for all the set of natural numbers. So this is about the solution of question number 10. If you like this video, please subscribe to the channel NCERT Maths Tutor to get more regular updates. Thanks for watching.